The great Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak relates. He relates that on one of my journeys to Hajj, from a distance I saw something black. When I got close there, I saw it was an old woman. I greeted her with Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakat. And this old woman, given an answer to my salam, she replied from the verse of the Quran, giving an answer, Salamun qawla min rabbir rahim. I asked her, Ki Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on you. Ki ma tasna'ina fi hadha al-makan. Ki what are you doing in this place? Yet again she replies from the verse of the Quran, reciting the verse of the Quran, Ki wa man yudlilillahu famaluhu min had. Ki whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lead astray, that nobody can guide that person. He says from this verse of the Quran, I realized that this old woman was lost. And I asked her, Ka ayna turideen, where do you intend to go? Yet again she replies from the verse of the Quran, سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي أَسْرَى بِعَبْدِهِ لَيْلًا مِّنَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ الْأَقْصَى. He glorified is the one who took his servant in part of a night from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa. He says from this verse of the Quran, I realize that she has already been to Masjid al-Haram, she has already done her Hajj, and now she is making her way to the third Haram, to Masjid al-Aqsa. I asked, أنتي منذ كم في هذا الموضع. That how long have you been sitting here and have been in this place? And she replied yet again from the verse of the Quran, ثلاث ليال سوية, that I have been here for 3 consecutive nights. I said to her, yeah, I don't see any food and drink with you. What do you eat? And yet again she replies from the verse of the Quran, هو يطعمني ويسقيني, that the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives me food, and the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives me drink. I asked, فَبِأَيِّ شَيْءٍ تَتَوَضَّئِينَ, what do you make your wuzu from? And she replied yet again from the Quran, فَإِنْ لَمْ تَجِدُ مَاءً فَتَيَمَّمُ صَيِّدًا طَيِّبًا, that if you cannot find water, then make tayammum with the earth. I asked, that I have some food with me, would you like to eat? This time she recited the verse of the Quran, ثُمَّ أَتِمُّ الصِّيَامَ إِلَى اللَّيْلِ, that complete your fast till the night. And from this I realized that she is fast. I said to her, do you know when a person is on a journey it is permissible for him not to fast? Allah has given rukhsa, Allah has made it easy. This time she recites the verse of the Quran saying, وَأَن تَصُومُوا خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ, that if you fast, it is better for you. Now every answer she was giving was from the Quran. She was reciting the verse of the Quran. So I said to her, لِمَا لَا تُكَلِّمِينَنِي مِثْلُ مَا أُكَلِّمُكَ, why do you not speak to me in the manner that I'm speaking to you? Yet again she recites the verse of the Quran, مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيمٌ عَتِيمٌ, he and she does not utter one single word except there are angels waiting to record this word. I then ask, فَمِنْ أَيِّ النَّاسِ أَنْتِ, which people are you from? And she replied from the verse of the Quran, وَلَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ إِنَّ السَّمْعَ وَالْبَصَرْ وَالْفُؤَادْ كُلُّ أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْؤُولًا. Say not of which you have no knowledge, verily the hearing, the sight, the heart, everything will be questioned on the day of judgment. I said, I've made a mistake, forgive me. This time she recites the verse of the Quran, لَا تَثْرِيبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْيَوْمَ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ, there is no reproach on you, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you. I ask, will you allow me to mount you on my camel so we can quickly catch the caravan? She replied yet again from the verse of the Quran, وَمَا تَفْعَلُ مِنْ خَيْرٍ يَعْلَمُ اللَّهُ, whatever good you do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows of it. From this I realized that she's agreed, and I made my camel sick. And she said this time, قُلِّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُدُّ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ, tell the believers to lower their gaze. And I lowered my gaze, and she mounted. As she was about to mount, the she-camel made haste, and her clothes ripped. And she recited the verse of the Quran, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ, that every calamity that you are afflicted with is due to your deeds. She mounted, reciting the dua yet again from the Quran. سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي سَخَّرَ لَنَا هَذَا وَمَا كُنَّ لَهُ مُقْرِنِينَ وَإِنَّا إِلَىٰ رَبِّنَا لَمُنْقَلِبُونَ. I took the rein of the camel and I began to run and shout. This time she recites the verse of the Quran, وَقْسِدْ فِي مَشِّكْ وَغْلُمْ مِنْ صَوْتِكْ. That be moderate in your walking and lower your voice. I began to walk slowly, and this time I began to recite poetry just to keep myself occupied. And she says yet again from the Quran, فَقْرَأُوا مَا تَيَسَّرَ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ. Read whatever's easy from the Quran. I said to this woman, كَأُوْتِيْتِ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. That you have been given a lot of good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you. Yet again she replies from the verse of the Quran, كَوَمَا يَذَّكَّرُ إِلَّا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. Can none receive admonition, none receive nasihat, except men of understanding. He says, I began to walk slowly, and after a while I asked, do you have a husband? And this time she relates the verse of the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَسْأَلُوا أَنْ أَشْيَاءَ إِن تُبْدَ لَكُمْ تَسُؤْكُمْ. Hinting that I shouldn't be asking with regards to things like this. He says, I remained quiet, and I did not speak to her thereafter till we reached the caravan. When we reached the caravan, I asked who she had come with and who was inside that caravan that was related to her. And she recited the verse of the Quran, كَالْمَالُ وَالْبَنُونَ زِينَةُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. That this wealth and these children are the zenith of this dunyavi life. And I understood from this that she has children. And then I asked her, كَوْمَا شَأْنُهُمْ فِي الْحَجِ. What are they doing on Hajj? This time she recites the verse of the Quran, وَعَلَامَاتِ وَبِالنَّجْمِ هُمْ يَحْتَدُونَ. And I realized from this that they were guides, and they were guiding this caravan towards Baytul Maqdis, towards the third Haram. Thus I went right to the front and I asked, what are their names? This time she recites the verses of the Quran, وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا يَا يَحْيَ خُذِ الْكِتَابَ بِكُوَّةٍ. And I realized that their names were Ibrahim, Musa, Yahya. I called, Ya Ibrahim, Ya Musa, Ya Yahya. And before I know it, there are three youngsters before me. Their faces are beautiful as the moon. And she says to her children, yet again reciting a verse of the Quran, إِبْعَثُ أَحَدَكُمْ بِوَرِقِكُمْ هَذِهِ إِلَى الْمَدِينَةِ فَلْيَنْظُرْ أَيُّهَا أَزْكَى طَعَامًا فَلْيَأْتِكُمْ بِرِزْقٍ مِّنْ. That go, one of you fetch food. One of them goes and fetches food and presents it before me. And she says yet again from the verse of the Quran, كُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا حَنِيئًا بِمَا أَسْرَفْتُمْ فِي الْأَيَّامِ الْخَالِيَةِ. To eat and drink. And I said to the children, كَالْآنْ طَعَامُكُمْ عَلَيَّ حَرَامًا حَتَّى تُخْبِرُونِي بِأَمْرِهِ. That your food is haram on me, and I will not eat your food till you inform me with regards to this person. And they informed him, كَهَذِهِ أُمُّنَا, that this is our mother. For 40 years she has not spoken except from the Quran. She has not said a single word outside the Quran. Anything that we ask, anything she has to say, she will recite a verse of the Quran, fearing that she may say one word from the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and her abode will become the fire of hell. It is exactly the hadith of Rasulullah, إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ لَيَتَكَلَّمُ بِالْكَلِمَةِ. Sometimes a person utters a word from the pleasure of Allah. He doesn't think much about this word, but this word proves to be so powerful in the eyes of Allah that because of this, his ranks are raised in paradise. وَإِنَّ الْعَبْدَ لَيَتَكَلَّمُ بِالْكَلِمَةِ مِنْ سَخَطِ اللَّهِ. And sometimes a person says a word from the displeasure of Allah. He thinks nothing of this word, but this word proves so powerful in the eyes of Allah that because of this, he is thrown into the fire of hell. So for 40 years, she protected her tongue. She safeguarded her tongue, fearing that she may utter one word that proves so fatal that because of this, that she becomes the inhabitant of hell. And because of this, she would recite her Quran and talk from the Quran and give answers from the Quran. The great Abdullah ibn Mubarak replies, ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ. Waqi, that is the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives this to whoever he wishes. These were our elders, and this is the reason that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this tongue, that we either benefit ourselves by being able to say what is inside our heart, express what is inside our heart, and by remembering the Almighty Allah by reciting the Quran, or by benefit others, by teaching others good, by teaching them the Quran, by teaching them the Hadith, by telling them to do good things, enjoining good and forbidden evil. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this blessing.